Most of you have the same question in your mind that how the Samsung Galaxy M20 gonna perform in daily life, as this device ships with Samsung's new 14nm based Exynos 7904 mid-range SoC coupled with Mali G71 GPU. Now looking at the AnTuTu and benchmark score, you can clearly say that it is not gonna perform as good as the Qualcomm Snapdragon 660 or the Mediatek Helio P70. But here you get all of the basic needed sensor for better gaming experience, and because presence of the 5000mAh of battery, you can expect long time of gameplay on the Galaxy M20, which is really impressive at this pricing. Now also with the Samsung Galaxy M20, you get something called the game launcher. It is not like the Honor device's GPU turbo technology, but this is a little software feature that you also find on the Samsung or the OnePlus devices called the gaming mode. Now, if you want a balanced performance or if you want more power, you don't play games on your phone, just go to the more power saving mode. Or if you want better performance and if you like to play PUBG and Aspal 9 at maximum graphics settings, then definitely turn on the maximum possible performance boost with a game launcher. So whenever you're gonna open any game, then you find some included gaming tools in the navigation bar, which is pretty similar that you get on the Asus Zenfone 5Z called the Game Genie mode. It just the software implements to give you better gaming experience, and the game launcher is pretty good on the Samsung Galaxy M20 to provide you better gaming experience. Now whenever you tap the gaming tool on the navigation bar, you have some of the options like no alert during game. So if you want to avoid messages and call during playing PUBG, so definitely you can turn it on and avoid all of the messages and calls. Now also they have some of the shortcuts you needed for any of the application to multitask while you play games. Also you can do that and add some of the application to your gaming tools. Now also you can record the whole gameplay video at 1080p. They also have the screenshot option, screen touch lock option to misplace your hand on the navigation bar. Also you can lock down the navigation keys. So these are some of the software tricks or software gaming tools that you get with the Samsung Galaxy M20 to improve your gaming performance. Now here it is about 9:31 PM and I already charged up the Samsung Galaxy M20 5000mAh battery to 100% to give you a brief idea how the game performance works and is there any battery drainage, because most of you have the same question that how the Galaxy M20 gonna perform in the game PlayStation and also how good is the battery life on this device. So this video will definitely give you a brief idea on this. Now the default setting for the PUBG gameplay is for balance and medium settings, but also you can play this game at HD graphics with high settings with the realistic mode. So we're gonna play this game at this graphic settings. And also if you find any background noises in the gameplay, just ignore it because I don't use mic to record this video. Now while in the aircraft, I don't find any lag, but while jumping from the fighter plane until you reach on the ground, there is a bit of frame drops and you can't play PUBG with this type of lag. But let's see, is there any difference when you reach on the ground and is there any frame drops when playing PUBG? So let's just wait and see. But after reaching on ground and playing PUBG for a few minutes, I don't find any lag or any frame drops, which is really surprising for me because most of the budget smartphones like the Nokia 5.1 Plus or the Asus Zenfone Max Pro M1, they can't even handle the PUBG at HD high graphics with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 636 or the Mediatek Helio P60. But this new Samsung's Exynos 7904 handles the PUBG with HD high graphics without any frame drops on the ground. There is a bit of frame drops while you jump from the plane or the fighter plane, but after reaching the ground, still I don't find any lag or any frame drops, which is really surprising. So let's now enjoy the game and let me know in the comment section what you think about the gameplay and also if you find the M20 is better for you. Now, after playing PUBG for 30 minutes with maximum brightness and volume, there is only 6% of battery drainage, which is really impressive. While playing PUBG, there is no heating after the recent update, and because of the plastic body, the heat emission is really great here. However, you get some heating issue on the fingerprint area, but it is not as bad as the metal devices because there you get the polycarbonate body, so the heat sinking is really great and it cools down very quickly. Now here it is about 12:06 a.m. and the battery percentage dropped to 94%. So let's now play another game which is called Asphalt 9 with high graphics settings, because both of these games is definitely a lot of people love these type of games, the Asphalt 9 for racing and PUBG for adventure. So action and adventure, definitely PUBG right now catching up a lot of craze. So definitely you can play PUBG with high graphics with HD settings on the M20 without any lag or frame drops. Now playing Asphalt 9 with the high quality graphics, there is no lag, there is not even a single frame drop, and let's just play this game for 30 minutes and let's just see how the battery drainage on the Galaxy M20 with the Samsung 14nm based Exynos 7904. Now if you find any type of background noises in the gameplay, definitely ignore all of them, because I don't use a professional mic to record all of these videos. I just use my phone camera, so just ignore and thanks. Now after another 30 minutes of Asphalt 9 with high visual settings, the battery drops to 87%. Now looking at all the stats, I can say the Samsung Galaxy M20 with the new Exynos 7904 can handle all the games with ease. Helping with the game launcher, it helps a lot to improve the gaming performance on this device, and with the 5000 mAh battery, you can expect longer time, longer duration of gameplay on this device, which is really great. If you want to purchase the Samsung Galaxy M20, all the links in the description box, go there and purchase one for yourself. So guys, that's it for this video. Let me know what you think about this video, and if you like this video, you know what to do. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.